A little bit of a surprise this evening, a special guest.
Hi guys, I'm Lucas Moura, and during this difficult time, we need to find a way to keep our kids active and healthy. So today we're gonna do a fitness session for the kids.
If you can all hear me, give us a wave, just so I know you can all hear me nice and clearly. Fantastic. Welcome to our virtual player development program. So my name's Danny. I work for our global football development team. And we felt that as we're in our second national lockdown, it would only be right for us to run a virtual PDP session while you guys can't attend in person. First of all, make sure you've got plenty of space around you. Obviously, I'm conscious you're all inside. Please make sure there's nothing valuable nearby that could be damaged. I don't want any angry parents contacting me around things being broken. So please make sure you've got plenty of space. And what you will need for the session is a football. Obviously, this is a football session. And we'll also need two cones or two objects that you can use as part of your sessions. That's fantastic. A little bit of a surprise this evening is we have a special guest joining us to help us with our technical challenges. And coming to us live from Hotspur Way is our very own Lucas Moura. Lucas, how are you?
How are you, my friend?
Very well. Everything okay at Hotspur Way?
Yes, everything's okay. I'm very happy to meet you today.
Excellent. Well, listen, thank you for joining
us. Hi, guys.
We've got some very excited kids. Everyone give Lucas a wave. Fantastic. So, Lucas, thank you for your time. You're going to show us some different challenges for the guys to work on while they're at home. So, Alex, I'll hand over to you to talk through part one of our session.
Thanks, Dan. So, guys, if you're in your space now, if you want to use your two cones to set up a distance that's probably around 5 or 6 steps apart, that's if you've got that space. If not, do your best to kind of make it as big as you can. Okay, super. So we're going to start off with some bell touches. Lucas is going to help us with the demonstrations. So you're going to work from the cone that you're at to the top cone with your right foot only. And then you're going to work from the cone that you reach back to the start with your left foot only. Okay. The aim is to use the inside and the outside of that one foot just to move the ball from outside to inside. So you're going to make a zigzag shape.
Let's go.
Just working those insides and outsides like Lucas is doing. Here we go. Excellent.
Good. So right foot on the way up, left foot on the way down.
Good, Ethan. I like that work, Ethan, on the carpet as well.
Let's go.
Very good, Sophie.
Very good, Ethan.
Another 10 seconds, guys. Well done.
Georgia.
Yes, good.
Very good, guys. Yeah, that's it.
Super. And just stop it there when you get back to the cone. We're going to have a little break. And then we're going to go for one more set of the same touches.
Leah.
Okay, this time you're going to do the same touches, but a couple of things to think about. Okay, you're going to keep your knees a little bit more bent, so you're lower to the ground. And you're just going to try and get your arms out to the sides just to help you to keep your balance. Okay, let's go then. Jump back up.
That's it. Let's go, Lucas.
Good. Nice and bendy with your knees. Keep yourself low to the floor.
Excellent. Like that, Sophie. Like that you've got two people working together.
Well done, guys. Look at Sophie.
She must be tired, Lucas.
Sophie, well done.
That's it. Keep
okay,
going.
Guys, and just relax there. Well done. Okay, we're going to move on now. We're going to move on to a different touch. We're going to call these ones messies. Okay, so we're going to work the ball. Two touches on each foot. So now you can work with both feet from start up to the next cone. It's one on the outside of your right, one on the inside. Then you flip over to your left, one on the outside, one on the inside.
Let's go. Come on. So, guys, if you're not sure how to do it, watch Lucas. He's showing us how it's done. Good, Nathaniel. Keep working.
Good work, Georgia. Very nice.
Well done, Sophie. Ethan, very good. Very good.
How long we got, Al?
Another 10 seconds to go. Keep the ball nice and close. Make sure you're moving it across your body.
Keep moving. Well done.
And relax here. Well done. Have a little break. Same as before, we're going to do another set. Really try and keep that ball close, guys. Don't let it run away from you. Make sure you're keeping it under control all the time. Oh, we've got a cat apparently has joined us, or a tiger, I think it is. Okay, we ready? Another set.
That's it. Get that ball working from side to side.
Good. 10 seconds to go. Keep that ball moving.
Nathaniel, what is doing?
Nice, Ethan. Very good. Nice and tidy. Good boy. And time. Relax there, guys. Well done. Okay, we're going to move on to our third touch. These ones are Lennon's. So you might have done these before at your PDPs. So for this one, we're going to go back to using right foot to the top, left foot back to the start. You're going to point your toe down and you're going to push the ball forwards in a straight line with your laces. Okay, so toe to the floor, touches forwards with your laces. Lucas, can you do a demo for us?
Of course, let's go.
Thank you. So just pushing the ball, good, right foot to the top and then left foot working back to the start. Okay, guys, we got it. 3, 2, 1, off you go.
Come on. Well done, Cordelia. Cordelia. Sophie's very funny.
Good boy, Ethan, very good.
Very good, Ethan. Georgia. Tracy. Yeah, well done, guys. Well done.
And time. Relax here. Have a little break. So we're going to go last touches. We've got these ones. There are Moura touches. So you're going to work the ball up to the top with the sole of your foot. So you're going to roll it. When you get to the top cone, you're going to change foot and you're going to roll it back with the other foot. Okay? You're looking to get nice control of the ball and just roll it with your sole. Okay? Lucas, a demonstration.
So just like you're trying to beat a defender, Lucas, in the game.
Good, thank you. Okay, guys, you ready? 3, 2, 1, off you go. Last little bit, and then we're going to have a break.
Come on, keep moving. Let's go.
Good, Georgia, really good.
Everyone, good. Good, Cordelia, Ethan, Sophie, very good.
Good, 10 seconds to go, guys. Keep working. Last little bit of energy.
Keep moving, boys, guys, girls, everyone.
Good, and relax there, guys. Well done. Give yourself a big pat on the back. Well done. Lots of excellent work.
Excellent. Great work. Thanks, Alex. So we're going to go into the next part of our session now. So for this bit, you're going to need to bring your cones slightly closer together. So Lucas, you might want to bring your two cones slightly closer. And what we're going to do for the last 10 minutes of the session is focus on doing some figure of eight work. So Lucas, again, is going to show us how it's done. But the idea of doing this work is to try and help you guys become better at controlling the ball and moving it in different directions and using different parts of your feet as you've done so far. So to start with, everything's going to be using your right side only and your right foot. So Lucas, if you want to show us just a figure of eight through in between your two cones, round to the top and then back and work through twice. Off you go.
Let's go.
So just working your right side, work up to the top, round and then back through the middle. And we're going to keep working on this for 30 seconds. So we're just focusing on getting lots of touches of the ball, moving the ball in different directions and trying to work as quickly as we can. But that's not the most important thing. It's important that we work at a good quality and then build up the speed if we need to. So 30 seconds, guys. Are we ready?
Come on. Nice
Let's go.
Easy.
3, 2, 1. Off you go. 30 seconds. Get working. Just using your right side. Try and use
Very good, Ethan.
Try and take lots of touches of the ball. Good.
Georgia.
10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Really, really good. One thing to practice when you're doing this, try and keep the ball as close to you as you can and try and make sure that you're working your feet in between. Lucas, any tips on this one from you?
Exactly. No, you were perfect on what you said.
Listen, you're too kind. You're too kind. Okay, so we'll go one more time on the right side. See if you can go a little bit quicker this time. 3, 2, 1. Off you go. Let's see who's working hard. Nathaniel, keep moving. Keep moving.
Same. Well done.
Oh, we now know we've got Sophie and Felicity working together. There we go. Oh, she's chasing a ball around the sofa.
Sophie.
Keep going. Last 10 seconds. 10. 9,
keep moving.
8, 7, 6, last 5, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Really good. Okay, so Lucas, as you'll know, it's important to work on both sides. So this time we're going to work just using our left foot. So if you don't mind just showing us so the guys can observe you in action. So just using your left side. If you watch Lucas, he's using different parts of his feet, but he's just focusing on keeping that ball nice and close and keeping his feet following the ball. Everyone give me a thumbs up if that makes sense. If you're ready to go. Okay, see if you can impress Lucas as much as you've done so far. Here we go, 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Well done.
Good, Ethan, well done.
Well done, Yasmin, keep working.
Keep going, Nathaniel.
15 seconds left, keep working. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay, last little challenge. So Lucas is going to show us this final one. We're going to work our right side up to the top and back, and then we're going to work our left side. So we're going to do one on our right and then one on our left. So Lucas, do you want to just show us what that looks like, please?
All right, let's go.
So exactly the same as before. So just working right side to the top and then left side on the way back. Now, what we're going to do to make this a little bit more exciting to finish, we're going to make it a race. So you're going to have to work up and back 2 times, and then you've got to pick your ball up and hold it up in the air so we can see who does it the quickest. Now, Lucas, because you've been so good at the demos, I think it's only right that you judge who the winner is. So I'm going to put all that pressure on you.
Let's go. Come on.
Okay, so set yourselves up. Don't start yet. We're going to go at the same time, and it's a race. So it's got to be as quick as you can. And we're looking to see who can work through twice through. Ready? On your marks. Set. Go. Let's go 2 times through. Who's it going to be? You've got to work twice through. One on your right, one on your left. And then when you're done, pick your ball up so we can see who's finished.
Ooh. Whoa.
Ooh, very good. Keep working. So, Lucas, who was the winner for you?
Everyone did very, very well. But the winner for me was Ethan.
Ethan, well done. Round of applause for Ethan.
Hi, Ethan.
Really, really good. Okay, I think it's only right we do this one more time to give everyone a chance to beat Ethan. So we're going to do exactly the same thing, but the challenge now is, can you be as quick as Ethan?
1, 2, 3, go!
Let's go. Who's it going to be?
Twice. Come on, let's go.
One on your right, one on your left.
Keep moving, keep moving. Come on, come on.
It's a bit tighter this time. Lucas, who was it?
It was difficult to say. That one was too close. But I think the winner is Sophie.
Yeah, Sophie, well done. Round of applause.
Well done, Sophie.
Really, really good. Now, guys, unfortunately, we're reaching the end of our session now. I'm conscious, Lucas, of your time. So before you go, I think it would be great just to ask you a couple of questions. And I think if there's any of the guys that would like to ask a question, I think it would be great. Just to kick it off from my side, I think, what advice would you give to these young players in terms of developing themselves and becoming the best player that they can be?
Just to give your best always. When you do your training session, you need to give your best. You need to enjoy what you are doing, and do it with your heart. Never give up. and believe in yourself.
Just one from me, Lucas, if that's okay. So we have a big emphasis across all our programs, same as this evening, on using both feet. So a lot of the stuff we've done has been on the left and on the right. How important do you think that is for these young players growing up so they become balanced when they get older?
That's very important, especially when you are young, to train your both legs, right and left, because you can become a complete player. Like Sonny, for example, who can finish with his right, his left, exactly in the same way.
And Lucas, I'm happy for you to choose someone that you'd like to ask you a question.
Come on, Zen.
How did it feel to score the winner to take Tottenham to the Champions League final?
Good question. It was amazing. That day was unbelievable. The best day on my career so far. To score 3 goals, Champions League semi-final with my left foot was an amazing feeling. At the end of the game, I just said to myself, I will be close to the box because the game is almost finished. We have 10 seconds. And when I see the ball in front of me, I just said, I will shoot. Even if I shoot the ground, I will shoot. And let's see what will happen. And that game will be in my heart forever.
Fantastic question, Zane. And again, reinforces some of the messages about the importance of practicing on both feet. Amazing. Lucas, thank you so much for your time. I'm conscious that we've slightly overran. So thank you very much for your time this evening.
We have more questions, no problem.
Sure. Yeah, okay.
Georgia, let's go. No problem.
Who's your favorite football team to play against?
My favorite opponent, you mean? let's say Barcelona, because I am a big fan of Lionel Messi, and it's always very difficult to play against them, and against Messi, of course. So I would say Barcelona.
Would you like to ask a question, Ethan?
He did very well. Let's go, Nathaniel.
Who is the hardest goalkeeper you've ever played against?
The hardest goalkeeper? It's not because he's Brazilian, but Alisson is very good. It's very difficult to score against him. And I would say Hugo Lloris as well, because I'm a big fan and I see him every day in the training session. And for me, he's top 3 in the world.
How old were you when you started playing football?
5-6 years old. I was very, very young, and football was always on my blood. So I love to play football, and I enjoy it a lot when I am on the pitch, and I play with my heart. You know, football is my life.
Who was a big influence on you growing up, Lucas, in terms of players, coaches? Who was an inspiration for you?
So in Brazil, we have a lot of great players. When I was young, I loved to see Ronaldinho, Ronaldo, Robinho. So players like this who has ability to play, you know, and this very good skills and the pace. A lot of Brazilian players, but these three was an example for me.
Yeah, not a bad selection of players anyway. Not bad at all. Thank you for your time.
No problem, my friend. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lucas.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. It was a pleasure for me to meet you.
Lucas has obviously left the call. I just wanted to say a massive well done and a thank you for joining us this evening.
Bye, guys.
Thank you. Bye.
Well done. See you later.
Bye-bye.
Mike House, well done.
I hope you enjoyed that. And why don't you have a go at home? And it will be good for you.